We've seen roughly over the last 12 months about 10 points of cost inflation, cost of goods inflation coming into our business. So at $12.7 billion of sales, think about that. That's kind of at a cost-adjusted basis, that's about $1 billion of cost of goods increases coming through our business. And we've seen it in three main areas. The first has been on the commodity markets. So because we sell so much animal feed and pet food, things like corn prices, things like soybeans, wheat, sunflowers, all those sorts of things, steel, have been heavily impacted our cost of goods. We price on our animal feed, as an example, monthly with our vendors. So as corn prices, for instance, are now kind of at another all-time high, they kind of peaked last spring, moderated a bit, now back up. A lot of that Ukraine-driven. We're kind of constantly monitoring that, flowing that into our forecast, looking at our moving average cost. Same thing, the second biggest, so that's one-third of that, call it billion-ish cost of goods that have been up. The second one-third is really our vendors' cost to serve. So they've got inflation running through their business, and some of that gets passed along to the tune of roughly a third of our cost of goods, and we work with our vendors on kind of cost justification worksheets. And then the remaining one-third is supply chain. And that's a mix of higher freight cost here in the United States, and then certainly higher import cost due to containers. And on the container side, so we buy 80, 85, sometimes up to 90% of our products on contract. The remainder we fill in with spot rate, in the spot market. And as we all know, last year, we'd historically buy contract rates at, depending on the port to port, but call it $3,500, $4,000 a container. And then the spot rate usually was a little higher than that, but not, extreme. And then last fall, we all read about these in the newspapers, but I mean, the spot rate was up $20,000, $25,000, and then if you were desperate, I know there are folks who paid even more than that. And so it's been incredibly volatile. Every single time you end up, agreeing to higher shipping costs or container cost or, commodity increase, those costs have to immediately make their way back into the forecasting systems, so that way you can continue to look at your landed cost. And we real-time look at that. We're looking at it on a weekly average, but then a rolling 3 months, and then certainly on a rolling 12. And as we look ahead, I think we're in an environment where inflation's persistent, certainly till this time next year. I think there's at least 12 more months of inflation coming through our country and through the business. And then perhaps some potential moderation as interest rates get up and inflation maybe moderates a little bit to the two come in line. And then I think we can start to get some things balanced back out here.
Yeah, I know recently you spoke with the president about inflation, but also too, when it comes to a lot of people don't understand, even when it comes to the products and the free market. We make enough corn and wheat in this country where we don't ship it out. I mean, we do ship it out to China and others, but we mostly keep it here. You would think that the price wouldn't be that high, but it doesn't matter because you're tied to the free market, to the capital market. So the prices are going up because of the war in Ukraine. When you spoke with the president and you talked about these inflationary pressures, can you give us a little bit of what was discussed?
Yes. So it's honored to be able to speak with the president a couple weeks ago by phone for about 15 minutes. And we really talked about two main things. On the supply chain side, we talked about OSRA, the Ocean Shipping Regulations Act, and the importance of getting that passed, which it did pass Congress and then signed by the president last Thursday. The goal there is really to enable a more transparent, to some degree, slightly higher regulated kind of container shipping market. As you all know, there's less than 10, I think, container companies in the world. Many of them domiciled in areas where there's a little less regulation and oversight. The idea is, how do we bring a little more transparency into that market and get a little more oversight here in the United States? And so, you know, with the goal of, you know, some of the pricing I think we all saw last year wasn't necessarily true market economics. And then the second thing he and I talked about was just inflation, generally speaking. And, you know, where we see our, you know, there's certain things that you know, I think the president and the administration have difficulty impacting on inflation because it's a Federal Reserve kind of monetary policy, M1, M2 money supply issue. But on as it relates to food and energy, which are really the two primary drivers of our inflation right now in the United States, if you look at core CPI versus consumer CPI. And so we talked about that, and you know, I shared with him an example of, we sell more bagged corn than anyone in the United States. It's obviously huge for animal feed, but also in things like other activities like for deers and birds and wildlife. And an average 50-pound bag of corn 2 years ago was $8. And now the average cost to us for a 50-pound bag of corn is over $14. So you've got over 60-70% price increase on a bag of corn. And so I was just sharing that with the president, you know, talking with him about the need for food and energy prices to come down, suggesting some things that we could do in the United States. You know, I shared with him as an example, when we made the decision to increase ethanol content in our fuel over the summertime, you know, I know that there's at least a portion of those out there that feel like that's going to help, you know, kind of fuel pricing. But the flip side is our farmers had not planted enough corn in expecting that. And so then all of a sudden it constrains the corn market. And then you see it, you know, make its way into grocery stores and make it way into things like animal feed. And so every market's got its unique circumstances. But, you know, it's humble to be able to share a few of those things with him. Pleased to see OSTR get passed last week. And pleased with the number of the other actions that we've taken, and then also hope that there'll be some more there that are considered, things like the import tariffs that were enacted in the Trump administration. You know, I think that's clearly a penalty on consumers in terms of it's a tax on consumers. You know, I don't think it's in many of those, there's no plans we'll ever, as a country and as manufacturers and companies, move those products out of China. So all you're doing is taxing the consumer. So are there some other things the administration can do to lessen the burden of inflation on Americans?